Today's topic touches upon a common concern among correctional officers. Today we'll discuss, debate, the proper space on your duty belt to place your handcuff case. Okay, wait, don't walk away. I was only kidding. Just pulling your leg. Hey, good joke, bro.
Why so serious?
My actual purpose for producing this content, this subject, is what to do if you run into a former client in public. I like saying client. So the other day I was surfing the web, frolicking around a correctional forum when I found a gentleman, a fellow officer seeking advice, asking a question. He says, have y'all ever encountered an inmate in a public place? Of course you have. How'd it go? Drop your story in the comment section below. It's a lot of fun, isn't it? Walking around Walmart, family in tow, and posted up by the cornflakes as a convict that you know. People get out of jail, prison, every day, all the time. In the shop where we shop, their kids go to school with our kids. That's why it's important to learn to communicate, to treat every person well, like a person, with some form of respect and dignity, even if you feel like they don't deserve it. That's probably a little heavy for you right now, so let's move on. So has this ever happened to me? Yes, a lot, frequently. And I don't always see them before they see me. And most of my interactions outside have been all right. An ex-inmate just wants to say hi and tell me about his life, their job, their sobriety, and all of that is awesome, encouraging, and at the same time, a little disturbing. Unnerving, because here's this guy, this inmate, occupying the same aisle, breathing the same air as my little girl. And now my two worlds, my personal life and my professional life, collide. There was this one time, this one afternoon, I was enjoying a little rendezvous with the missus. I meant for lunch, you are sick. When two vehicles pulled up all slow and kind of suspicious. One car had the window cracked just enough so I could see inside. And I made eye contact with a guy that I recognized. He was a kid that had attempted to assault an officer in my facility. So he went to lockdown. And a day before he was set to go home, the hearing committee took all of his good time and sent him to the hole. Let's just say that he was less than excited that his stay had been extended. And since I was directly involved with the incident, I thought that he'd be, well, less than excited to see me. So I gave my wife a wink and told her to get in the car before whatever was going to happen happened and things went too far. So here's my first tip, and maybe my second. My first tip was to talk to people like people, to treat the population with a little respect. Don't be reckless with your words and your tone. If you need an example of what to do, hit up a vet. Watch how they carry themselves. It's a thing of beauty. And if you need an example of what not to do, watch the Stanford prison experiment. In particular, the conversation that the officers have at shift change. It's ugly. So tip two is to have a plan, an arrangement with the members of your family so they know when and where to go. Some officers have their people wander off and they catch up with them later. Some have a nod or a word or a phrase to let their loved ones know that there's an inmate around. There's no right or wrong way to do this. Just do something. Stay vigilant. Pay attention to your surroundings. So sorry, you may need to put your phone away. Not right now. Finish watching this video and then you can put your phone away. A lot of situations can be avoided if, well, you avoid them. If you see the potential for a problem and you remove yourself from the equation. So there's two quick tips for you, but before I continue, before I wrap it up, if you're getting some value out of this video, click that little like button. Thank you. That wasn't so hard now, was it? Lastly, the leaver of this question mentioned carrying a gun. A firearm. Now, I'm all for the Second Amendment and self-defense. I carry. But make sure you check your local laws and regulations regarding owning, registering, and transporting firearms in your area. Just Google concealed carry in your state and you'll find what you're looking for. Take a course. Go to the range. And to quote Outkast, don't pull that thang out unless you came to bang. Oh, you've never heard of Outkast? That's too bad. It was just a kind of a clever way to say don't be a cowboy if you don't have to be. Which is a nice way to say don't engage if you can safely get away. Guys, if you found value in this video, let me know in the comments below. And before you go, before you get too far down in the YouTube rabbit hole of EDC videos, like and share this video. All right, guys, that's all I got. Until next time, be smart, stay safe, stay sane, and we'll talk soon. I don't know what the point. Bye.